All right, guys, so this video is going to dive a bit deeper into Wix services and booking on Wix websites. So without further ado, let's jump right into this. And what I'm going to do for this video is I'm actually going to use a different website than the usual one that I've been using for these videos. This one has a really good booking form, so I want to go through and show you what it looks like, how it functions, and then what the behind the scenes is working like. So this is the Book Now page right here. So I'm in preview right now on the editor. So the homepage, and we come down and there is a link to the booking. So you want to make sure that people can get to your booking, not just up in the header here, but also in a big button somewhere called action. So they click that or they click up top and it brings them to the booking page. Now you can say whatever you want to say here and you can put in terms as well. That's kind of all up to you. But what I want to cover is this booking section right here. So when people come onto here, there's a couple things that you notice. It's very nicely laid out. Everything is grammatically the same, capital and then lowercase, capital, lowercase. So make sure that there's no typos here because that will totally ruin your credibility. And then these images are nice too. So as they zoom in, nothing gets cut off. Everything is just very neat and very well organized. And then when you come over here, you have how long the job or the service will take and how much it costs. Now people can hit these down arrows and it shows a little bit more information about it. You don't want to put a ton of information here because then when someone hits learn more, it takes them into a specific product page about it. And then it's a little bit harder for them to come back to your booking. So they have to find this button here and come back to your booking. So just keep this very simple and tell them what they're going to get, learn more, a little bit more in detail without going too extravagant and confusing anyone because you don't want to confuse people here. You want them to go all the way through and book. Once we're set here, people can come in and book. Brings them right to the calendar on Wix and they can choose from available times. So what I love about this is when an appointment gets booked, that time slot is taken up. So 5 o'clock is available on the 2nd, but then there's an appointment that day so people can't book for it. So people can only book when an appointment is available. And then they can choose their time here and they can go right through, hit next. And then they can put in the information that you need. So I'm going to show you in a bit here how to customize this section for what information that you need to collect when someone books a service. But then they just go through, put in their information here, they hit book it, and then it gives them a confirmation page. So let's go back a couple steps and go into the back end of this. So we'll go back to editor. And once we click on this section, we can manage services and we can do settings. So let's go into settings first. And now a lot of this is going to be design options. So you can change the font, you can change the layout. As you see, this is the strip layout, which I think is the best one, but you can change it to grid. It just changes what your services look like, but this is entirely up to you. So you can customize this and change it however you like it. Now, if you have different categories of products, then you can separate it with a category here. So if you have a lower end, a higher end, something for automotive, something for a house, then you can divide different services up. You can choose when you're making the service, which category it goes into. And then you can put a label so people can sort by different categories. We won't be worrying about that. And a lot of this, like I said, is very design oriented. So what we need to worry about is mainly add your information. And what this is going to do is it's going to bring us to a separate page here. And once this loads here, we'll be able to decide what information we need to collect when someone books an appointment. And here it'll give you standard options. You can change and you can edit what they are. And then you can also add on additional fields. So different boxes that people have to fill out. And now when you do add something on, you can decide if it's required or if it's not required. So if someone has to fill in that box or if it's optional. So that helps you gather the right information when someone's booking your service. And then while we're in this dashboard here, we'll come right over to booking services. So in booking services, this is the services that you offer and what people can book on your website. So here we'll just come in and you can add a new service. You upload the photo and then you can start filling out the information. So when we're in edit here, we can change everything about what this service is and what the offering is. So we can upload our photo right here. Easy to change it. You just upload it right to the website. Choose the name of it. Again, make sure that there are no typos in this. Choose the category that it's going into. As I said before, if you have automotive or if you have house, you can choose that right here. You won't need any taglines. I don't think you need to put that there. And then just that little description. Come down and you can decide who the staff member is. So if you have multiple people in your company, then you can choose who is an option for that. If you select multiple people here, then when someone's booking the service, they have options to choose from. They can go with you or they can go with someone else and they can choose who to book. So if there's two people, A and B, and A gets filled up for a 12 o'clock appointment, but B is still open, then the person can come in and they can book it with B if they would like a 12 o'clock appointment. So that does make it a little bit easier. And if you want to add someone, you can just hit add right here. You can add in their information. and then how long it takes for the actual service, and then what interval you want to accept jobs in. So this is a 30-minute interval. So if someone books at 12 o'clock, then that means that the service will take until 1 o'clock, and it won't accept another appointment until 1:30. Now that accounts for drive time. You can set this to whatever you would like here. And then what I like to do is I don't accept the payments right on Wix. So I actually send an invoice separately through PayPal because I collect payment after the service is done, not when someone's doing booking. So I set it on free here, and then I put in the manual price of what the invoice will be. That way someone can book the service. Then once it's done, on my end on the back, I can send the invoice through PayPal. But definitely feel free if your business does collect payment in booking, you can just turn paid on right here, and that way you can collect your payment when someone is booking. And then you have three options right here for the service location. If you are a studio, like a photography studio, and it's happening at your studio location, you can do my business address, and then you just set that in settings, and then people know when they book it, they have the address of where your studio is. Now, if it's happening at the customer's place, at their address, then you can select this button, and they input their address, and the information that you receive when someone books, it has their property address. Or you can do other, and you can just put in whatever you want here. So I always put on-site at property, and that's whatever address that they're gonna enter in the notes, that's where it's going to be. Probably wondering what the difference between this and customer's place is. There was a little bit of glitch on Wix a while ago, so I set it this way, that way it can never glitch again. Before, the glitch was if clients were booking multiple jobs in different addresses, for example, real estate, and they had new listings, they needed photo shoots at different places, then Wix was pulling the wrong address, the one from the previous shoot. So it was just a little minor issue that's actually probably fixed by now, but I just do it this way and it makes it so it's all manual and all the information comes to me exactly how I need it and there's no room for a glitch. So if you have any questions on that, let me know, but this is just a little workaround. Go ahead and hit save service right there and then it'll bring you right back to all your list of the other services. So just fill this out with all the services that you offer and you can drag them to order it however you'd like to order it. You put one in front of the other, however you prefer to order your services. Then we'll come over to booking calendar over here. And this will show you what jobs are currently booked, but also what I wanna do is show staff hours. So you can add in who your staff members are here. So this is where you add in staff member A, staff member B, and you can determine what their hours that they are available are. So if you've already set default business hours for your business in general settings on the Wix site, then you can actually just choose default work hours and then it automatically pulls in whenever your business is open, you're available to book. But you can also come down and do set staff members hours. So you can say that if that person isn't available Tuesdays from 8 a.m. to 10 every day, you can set that as not available. So they will never be able to be booked in the calendar during that time period. So you can set custom staff member hours here. And once that's set, just go ahead and hit save and add as many staff members as you need here. Now, something that I really like about this is probably my favorite feature about the whole Wix services and Wix booking is that you can sync it to a calendar. So each of these staff members, you can sync it to their personal calendar or Gmail, whatever it is. So when someone does book them, it gives them an email, shoots them an email and says you were just booked, and then instantly syncs to their actual calendar that they can check on their phone, computer. It's the work calendar. So it shows you now have an appointment that's blocked off for this time period on those days. So you don't have to use a scheduling service or any automation. Wix does it entirely included and instantly too. It just syncs right up to their calendar. So there's no confusion on when they're booked, when the jobs are. Looking forward, they can check their calendar and see what's booked, what's not, and when they have to be on the job. And then we'll come back to main menu over here, and we'll jump down to settings and scroll down to booking settings down over here. Now in your booking settings here, you can set the default hours that your business is open that I was talking about just before. You can add in a booking policy that you really won't need to do. And then also you can customize your booking form. This is the information that we were customizing on what information we collect when someone books. This is just another way to get to it. But also, and very importantly, you can send auto emails and reminders. So we'll jump into this right here. And now on this version of Wix Booking, it's not the highest one up, so you can't customize your reminder emails, but you can still send a confirmation email. So when someone books your service, you can customize the email that they get right into their email. Now this gives people that are booking peace of mind and allows you to confirm with them so there is no confusion that they are booked and they're scheduled, they're confirmed for that time. And then the cancellation email, I don't really use it, but if you have to cancel an appointment for someone, you can come into your Wix app on your phone or log in here and cancel the appointment, and it sends them an email just saying that it's canceled. 9 times out of 10, when someone does cancel an appointment, the way that I handle it is just go right into my calendar on my phone that's synced up to Wix, and I just delete that time slot. Now what that'll do is it'll sync backwards to Wix Booking and show that space as available again. So it works both ways. When someone books on Wix, it syncs to the calendar. When you delete something, it brings that time slot open again. So if someone does need to reschedule on the phone, you can just put them on speaker, pull up your calendar right on your phone that's synced to Wix, and you can just slide their appointment around. Now that'll change the availability on Wix too. So they will be rescheduled, plus their old time slot will become available for someone else to book. And then this reminder email right here, you can't customize it, but it actually sends out. So you don't have to pay extra for it to send out. For the longest time, I thought it didn't send out unless you paid for it because it's turned off, but it actually does. 24 hours before the appointment, it'll send out a reminder email. And it's very vague. It just says, "We're looking forward to seeing you tomorrow. Just wanted to send you a friendly reminder that we are scheduled at this time tomorrow." So you don't have to pay for that. If you want to customize that, then you do have to pay. It's about $100 extra per year. So I don't even pay for it. It's a very generic email. And unless you need it to be very specific instructions 24 hours before, then you won't even have to pay for it. It'll send for you. So those are the main things for Wix Booking. I'm just going to back out of here, back out of this as well. So everything we just covered will cover all the basics of how this functions, how it works. And if you have any additional questions, let me know in the comments. I'll clear it up for you. But the rest of this here, you just come into settings and play with the design. So you can do each of these drop downs here. And you can choose what the design looks like, what kind of text you put there, but that's basically it. So hopefully that helps you guys. If you have any questions, definitely let me know. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel if you want some more. If you want the lengthier Wix tutorial on the basics of how to get started, I'll link to that YouTube video as well. And then also, if you haven't made your Wix website yet, I'll put my referral link down in the description. It helps me long run. If you decide to stick with Wix down the road, it gives me a small commission and it costs you nothing extra. So if you want to support me that way, I really appreciate it. If not, don't worry about it. Otherwise, I will see you guys in the next video.